I have this little message. He said, if I have all it takes, then what's the problem? If I have all, if I have what it takes, if God has given me, then what's the problem? You're about to find out. If some of the answer is even in this text that I read. So I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit is telling you this morning to seize the moment. Amen. Take back your authority. Amen. However you laid it down, pick it back up. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. Take your authority back. Begin to make declarations of faith. Command the wind and the storm to change direction. Amen. Let them bring the resources. And not to drive them from you. Amen. Hallelujah. He said, go and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Ghost. So now watch. Those are direct words from Jesus. Do you know there are people preaching that there's only the Father and Jesus. That the Holy Spirit is not a third person in the Godhead. The Godhead is two. Even one of my brothers was trying to preach that to me and say God revealed it to him. I said, which God? I said, please. He said, Jesus said, you baptize them in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the if he wasn't a person, then why would he say baptized in his name? I said there are three that bear witness. The Bible says in the book of 1 John, he said, well, you need to check when that was written. I said, that's what unbelief does. You go and do research to doubt. Seven lost books in paradise. But you don't know John 3:16. You are reading antiquated philosophies that don't mean anything. Amen. That only plumes your pride. Yeah. But I love what Jesus said. He said, I thank you, Father, that you have kept this from the eyes of the wise and the prudent, and you revealed it unto babes. And I'm telling you this morning, take your life back. Take your money back. Take your relationship back. Take whatever Satan is trying to snatch from you. You have power to snatch it back now. So you go and teach all nations. That's the responsibility he gave you, not to just attend church. So go and teach it. That means you've proven it. Why does God allow battles in our life? Why doesn't he just let us, just cruise? Hallelujah. He's smarter than you. He knows what you need to develop the spiritual muscles to get to your destination. Amen. You know, a few years ago, they didn't understand how they can put all this power in a rocket. And then when you ignite it, as soon as it lifts up, it falls. It cannot penetrate gravity. And they had to sit down and calculate the amount of force it would take to overcome gravity Do you know what gravity is? It's actually the weight of the air from the surface to the end of the earth sitting on top of you. Otherwise, you'll be floating around. And you have to pierce through that force at a certain feet per second. Otherwise, it will push you back down. Watch. So they discovered that they needed to put clamps on the rocket that is equivalent to the force of gravity that will push it down. And when it's able to break free from it, then it will get out. Okay. You see how you're looking at me? That's exactly what God does. He knows what you're going to contend with. Even when the rapture happens, you still have to go through principalities and powers. And you better have your arm on. He has to put strength in you. He has to put vigor in you, faith in you, power in you. Hallelujah. That's why when you see, when they used to launch the space shuttle, when the thing ignites, boom! It's like an atomic bomb going off. I saw these very powerful nozzles that will spray 1 million gallons of water against the force of that explosion to counter it. Otherwise, the ground will split open in Florida. It can destroy the entire state of Florida. So the way you counter force is to meet it. We're not going to be doing stadium crusades. And we're running from imps. Hallelujah. I'm coming back in town to tell you that you need to get back on assignment. Hallelujah. I'm not telling you you guys didn't have good services. But I'm telling you I scoped you out. And some of you are not in your position. Amen. Huh? Where you getting discouraged over Mickey Mouse issues that you should have already overcome? Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. What is it new? What is new about the devil attacking you? You should be celebrating that you're going the right direction. Amen. Because if you don't meet him head on, you're walking with him. Isn't that what Elder Bobby reads to the, you know, deacons all the time? Paul says, I glory in infirmities, in distresses. It's our glory in these things. The sound I desire to hear is not just the shout in the sanctuary, but the shout at home. Mm-hmm. Are you following what I'm telling you? Faith answering the door. Eh? Confessions of faith coming forth. He said, go teach it to the nations. Amen. How can you teach it and you don't practice?
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah.
How many of you believe that he has given you power?
Amen.
Okay, put your hands down. How many of you know that he has given you power?
Amen.
In every glory fall, we invoke it. He says, I give you power to tread on serpents and scorpions. Serpents are trickeries. Scorpions are wounding things. He said, now, if you master these two things, you got the devil licked. Hallelujah. And he says, I've already given you all authority over those things. Okay? You're slow this morning. You didn't see where I'm going. See? He says, I give you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy. And here he says, all power is given unto me. In heaven and on earth. What is he telling you? I transferred what the Father gave me to you. I transferred it to you. Stop praying to me to do what I assigned you to do. He says, I've given it to you. Walk on them. W-A-L-K. Walk on them. So here's a little drill, and then I'll pray. So I'll leave time to preach my little message. Now watch. This is how you know whether you have received the power he gave you or not. Number one, where you are looking. Where your focus is. If you're looking down, you let go of what he gave you. That's the first test. Your focus. Where are you looking? When you're looking, what are you seeing? Because revelation comes from focus. When I preach to you, you see how deadly these things are. It doesn't matter what you have been given. If you don't use it, nothing will change. Nothing will change. So, when I'm testifying to a Muslim, so now if you meet Jesus, you will never serve Islam again. He said to me, oh, that's the same thing Muslims say. I said, then prove it. What's my little next test? When you are challenged, you will get up and prove it. Is there anything in your life saying that Jesus Christ is not Lord and he has not given you the power? Then get up and prove it to him. Amen. What are you praying? Prove it. Amen. When I run into devils, I don't pray. Why should I be praying? I've already prayed. You don't have time to pray. You start shooting. Before you finish, okay, Father, we thank you. You've already been shot. No, something should rise up. Hallelujah. Ooh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Something should stir up. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you that the man on the inside is getting up this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you that sons of God are getting up. Hallelujah. When I started this service, I heard the shout of a king. In the house. Glory. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Watch. Watch. The reason many people don't respect authority is because they don't have one. Because when you understand authority, you know that that's how the realm of the spirit is arranged. That's why when you understand it, you don't need to pray. When you have been sent, you have backup. I felt goosebumps. If I'm sitting in front of a witch doctor, I don't start praying under my breath. Oh, Lord, protect me. And this, what nonsense. Because I've already proven it. I have received it. So when I see him, I say, hey. I say, I have two angels with me. One on my right, one on my left. And if you try something, you might not wake up tomorrow. Hallelujah. He said, go. Amen. When you are told go, he said, I'm sending my power with you. I'm sending angels with you. I'm sending wisdom with you. Hey. How many of you can hear the call? Go. Not sit. Go. Not pray and be begging. Go. Go get the job done. Go run over devils. Go. He said, go and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Lo, I am with you. So every time I go to the village, I hear all sorts of things, but I go anyway. You need to learn that you've been sent. And he is with you. I mentioned that thing because I was telling the man, I said, well, see, I'm the only one that's going to the village. Even the king don't go to the village. The king ran away. I said, why don't you go to the village? He said, He said, that anointing you got, that's where you are going and coming. We don't want to go over there. And then we disappear. I said, chicken. Say, I'm with you. I mean, if you know he's with you. Yes. Hallelujah. How many of you know you've been given an assignment to teach all nations? Yes. Nations are not countries. Nations are ethnicities, yes. Family members, friends and relatives, yes. Associations, organizations. Teach them that Jesus Christ and that he has all power. Hallelujah. Amen. He has all power. Glory to God. Before I left town, I told you, if God starts getting fruit for what he has already done, he will do some more. I'm not telling you don't get counsel or don't get a prayer of agreement. But I'm telling you, the time has come for you to answer the door yourself.
Amen. Yes.
The time has come for you to stand up against the enemy yourself so you can develop the muscle you need. Yes. Hallelujah. Lord. Glory to God. Hey, Masataraba. Amakashi Krena Mahasa. Watch, Masebre Katama. As I was saying that, he says, I gave you power to tread. Hallelujah. Hey, so now, this is what you need to do. You got issues going on. You say, now when you get home, now, you say, okay, if it's money, okay, this financial problems, you get the bills. It's okay, I'm going to trade on you. In the name of Jesus, I trade on you. You need to act it out, hallelujah. Whatever it is, you walk on it. Serpents and scorpions and over all the powers of the devil. Watch. When I hear people talk, I say, these are unbelieving believers. Watch now, because you live in fear. And some people come to preach fear to me or threaten me with this and that. I say, you don't know where you are. God said to me, even if you're limping on one leg, I'm higher than all devils. Watch. He says, and nothing shall by
enemy.
Do you understand that? He said, by any means, no contraption, no scheme, no nothing. It won't work. I told you that. Something happened and half of the church left. And God said to me, go and eat. You don't need any fast. Why? He said, I drove them away. So I can bless you. They were sitting here hindering you. I drove all these unbelievers away from you. If I had that church here, we wouldn't own Eagle One. We wouldn't be doing all the things we're doing. We're in that fight now. But I told you it's a prelude to breakthroughs you've never seen. Amen. You have to know your patterns. You have to know the patterns. I've gone through these things for 21 years now. I know the patterns. It's the same thing that the enemy does over and over again. And it's the same thing that God does over. It's you that keeps thinking it changes. He says, I am the Lord. I don't change. He's the same. Yes. Hallelujah. So watch. As I'm walking, put your own stuff underneath my feet. Hallelujah. And then when I finish, you do yours. Hallelujah. I'm walking on serpents and scorpions and anything challenging me, opposing me, attacking me, trying to discourage me. You are under my feet. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He said that communion should be a celebration among friends who believe. This is a communion of faith, not a communion of unbelief. I come to it knowing he won for me. I have victory over Satan based on what he did. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I celebrate your victory now. In Jesus' name. I celebrate that you're taking back what belongs to you. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Let the celebration continue where you are this morning. The victory belongs to you. But as in natural life, just because something belongs to you doesn't mean you can even obtain it, even when property is left for children or for relatives. Sometimes they don't have money to pay the taxes. Faith is the currency to get what belongs to you. And what I've learned in this kingdom, until you put your foot down, Satan will keep riding over you, and God will not do anything. Jesus will not say anything. The Holy Spirit, you will even feel the anointing, and the enemy is still messing with you. You have to say, no, enough is enough. And then heaven will back you up. So now you must act out that message. Come on, go get pieces of paper, write it, bills or whatever they are, you lay them on the ground. You lay all this stuff on the ground, and then you walk on them and declaring it, walk on them. The foolish things confound the wise. That's what God does. You walk on them. You declare them. You should know that God knows what it takes. If he tells us that we are to walk on serpents and scorpions, that should tell us there's a mystery to it. You have to be looking down to see the enemy. Only looking up to see God. No problem should be in God's view. Glory to God. You have to fight this fight and win it. I know what I'm talking about. I've overcome devils, mountains, juggernauts, cities, principalities, powers, the occult. I have overcome all of them by the same faith, by the same power, by the same authority. It is now your turn to do it. Amen. And amen. There's nothing wrong with anyone agreeing with you in prayer. But the time has come, as God said in the message, for you to take what belongs to you, for you to assert your own right. You do it naturally. You don't let anybody boss you. Then don't let Satan boss you. I make sure whenever I write Satan, it has to be small letter. No devil gets any caps. You're small letter. You can't threaten me. You are not in my realm. I am seated in heavenly places in Christ. So you can't threaten me. Hallelujah. You see, if you don't know it, God said to me, don't challenge Satan. But if he picks any fight, I guarantee that it shall not prosper. It shall not prosper. This is the season where we are in our destiny. Are you aware of what's going on? Are you ready for the battle? Because the Antichrist and his folks will take over the earth and all those craziness. Isaiah 60 tells you that darkness shall cover the earth. Gross darkness, the people. He said, but your light, the glory light. Hallelujah. And what I love about it is, it's when you assert your God-given authority, you don't go beyond what God said. And one of my brothers shared a testimony with me years ago, how the fire of God was so strong on him, and he challenged Satan and said, he said he went through hell. He almost died twice. He's a doctor in Her Majesty's employment in the UK. Where his wife, not a doctor, and a practicing midwife. At the same time, she had done nursing, midwifery, and medicine. Had she not been there, he would have died. You don't challenge Satan. I don't have time to challenge anyone. But if you enter my God-given space, I have complete authority here. Amen. This is what you need to learn and act on it. And we can celebrate together. 770-994-3777. Prayer ministers will agree with you in prayer and put this fire and release it into you. You'll be quickened. Resurrection is a quickening spirit and power. Glory to God. It will happen for you. Amen and amen. You can write to me, P.O. Box 251, Union City, Georgia, 30291. All of that information is on your screen until you act on your faith and put a seed in the ground. Nothing will happen in this kingdom. But we love you. We're going to continue to thunder the word of faith this week. We have one more day. It will change your life forever. Receive in Jesus' name. God bless you. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.